A long and arduous trek up Bahrot Hill, 160 kilometers north of Mumbai, will take you to a set of caves that played a very important role in Parsi history. For 12 long years, these caves housed Iran Shah, the sacred fire of the Parsis. While little remains here, it is an important site in understanding the early history of Parsis in India. Most of what we know comes from the epic poem Kissa-e-Sanjan, the only narrative of this distant past.
So what we know about Bahrot essentially comes from the Kissa-e-Sanjan, which is this quasi-historical, terribly bad Persian poem written in 1600 AD, which tells us the story of the Parsis and the Parsis who came to Sanjan. And it also tells us the history of how they settled there, how they did well, how they grew, and how they dispersed to other parts of Gujarat. It also then tells us how Sanjan was attacked, and prior to this attack, the priests of Sanjan took the holy fire, the Iran Shah as it was called, which had been lit in memory of Sanjan, and they left with the Iran Shah and hid in the mountains of Bahrot.
The Parsis came to India from Iran, fleeing religious persecution between the 8th and 10th centuries CE.
It basically stretches back to 641 AD and the defeat of the last Sassanid emperor. The Kissa-e-Sanjan tells us that after the defeat of the last Sassanid emperor, which would put the date at either 641, which is the Battle of Nehawand, or 651, when Yazdegerd Sheriar was actually murdered, that for 100 years after this, a group of Parsis hid out in the mountains of Khorasan. This was because that region was still controlled by Sassanid princes for about 100 years post the Islamic invasion or the Arabic invasion. And after those areas were subjugated, they moved down to Hormuz. They stayed at Hormuz for about 30 years and then left from Hormuz for India.
According to Kissa-e-Sanjan, they first landed on the island of Diu, where they stayed for 19 years and then settled in this tribal belt. The settlement at Sanjan was named after the town in today's Turkmenistan. In 1463, the Parsis had to flee Sanjan after it was sacked by the invading armies of the Sultanate of Gujarat. They took refuge on Bahrot Hill in an old fort. There is, however, still some confusion on how long they stayed there.
So there is an issue of what is called 12 years and 14 years in the Kissa-e-Sanjan, which is rather casually mentioned. The debate is whether it was a 14 years in toto at Bahrot and Basda, or whether it was 2 years at Bahrot and 12 years at Basda. So the actual duration of the occupation at Bahrot is impossible to actually pin down. It could be, as I said, anywhere from 2 years to 12 years that they were at Bahrot. So Bahrot was definitely known to them. It wasn't like they were running away to some unknown location. That's quite obvious. There is a very, very large, impressive fort that exists on the top of the hill at Bahrot. It has a very, very good view of the surroundings, and you could see anybody inimical coming to you from a very, very long distance away in almost all directions. There are a large series of cisterns over there, which, whilst they do not hold water today, would have in all probability held enough water at that time for a sizable community to live on top. And at Bahrot, while doing clearance work in 2003-2004, what we've noticed is that there are a number of plinths of houses, so telling us that there was quite a number of people who lived there. The Bahrot fort itself was not in all probability built by the Parsis. So they were probably occupying a deserted fort over there, which probably belonged to perhaps the Rashtrakutas or the Shilaharas, and maybe even some of the later rulers of that area. So life would have been very difficult. There would have been no place to farm up there. Food would have had to be brought there. It's a minimum 2 hour trek to the fort, and it would not have been very viable in the long term. So it would have been a good lookout, a safe place to hide at, but it would not have been a place to live in for any considerable period of time.
When the situation improved, the Parsis moved to the dense bamboo forests of Bansda and then to Navsari, where the sacred flame was reconsecrated. In 1742, it was taken to Udvada, where it rests today.